me tell you about my best friend. He's a warm-hearted person who loved me till the end of people. Let me tell you about my best friend.
Okay, enough screwing around. Dang, this reminds me of like the Jailhouse Rock song from by Elvis Presley.
One threw a party in the county jail. The prison band was there and they began to wail. The band was jumping and the drum began to swing. You should have heard the locked out jailbird sing. Let it rock. Everybody let it rock. Everybody.
Governor's office in the jail. This is pretty neat.
Can't see it very well, but it says transferred to God knows where. 20th of February, 1923. He has no idea where he's going. And some stars.
Thomas Raley, who was apparently convicted for stealing some books, he was sentenced to serve his time in solitary confinement to contemplate his wrongdoing and is turned to religious guidance. Hmm. Well, that's one way to spend your time in jail.
Gaslighting, yeah, they probably used gas lamps in the days of old. Mary McDonnell.
Who can apparently be seen lying on a canvas mattress, which was stamp issue in prisons in the 1860s. Oh, that's creepy. Why do they have these things in there? They're so creepy looking. And I can also see my shadow on the floor. Mary is charged with neglecting her children, beating one of them and being drunk, accosting a gentleman. Her children will be taken to the Cork Workhouse while Mary serves a sentence for 1 month, including hard labor.
Try a cell. How's your jail time doing? You're lonely? Well, you shouldn't have done something bad and got in there then. Oh no. Why?
Solitary confinement.
Being Captain New Planet.
Why? Why would you do that to me? Look at these beds! How am I supposed to live? This is the hard one. This is the poofy one. Here we go. Hey, this is actually a pretty nice arrangement. Huh. Well, look at that. Yeah, this would be boring after a few months. Yep. Well, apparently I got sentenced to a month in here with hard labor for being Captain U Planet. All because I got distracted for 2 seconds at a gas station along the way here, and my family almost left me. Hi, Dad. Is that you?
Cornelius is reported as having been a notoriously bad character. He is serving a 1 month sentence for being drunk and disorderly. In fact, he was arrested on the very day that he'd been released after serving a 2 month sentence for being drunk and disorderly.
Not very smart. Yep, there he is, sleeping. Stop being drunk and disorderly. did my girlfriend?
Probably a lot. Like, get me out of here! Four in each cell. Oh wow. Misery loves company. So they took the clothes from the guys at night. Hopefully. And they hoped that the guys would not want to escape without their clothes. Yeah, I'm hearing just doors shut all over the place. With all these Jacob Marley chains. Edward O'Brien. Okay, Edward. What did I tell you about copyright music? You don't download illegal music off the internet, or else this happens to you. PSA, kids, don't steal music off the internet. Edward O'Brien is a well-known pickpocket, and at the age of 9, already has 7 previous convictions. On this particular occasion, he has been convicted of petty theft and has been sentenced to 3 weeks here at Cork Gaol with twice weekly whippings. After his sentence in the gaol, he will be sent to a reformatory school for 5 years. Ooh. But that was a pleasant experience. Not. Outside of the prison, looks pretty neat. Almost like the castles we've been looking at. Oh, there's like the outer wall. So here are 2 warders, off duty, playing cards. Wait a minute. Oh, this guy's cheating!
How could this happen to me? I made my mistakes, got nowhere.
Some of these things are fun to mess around with. The warder, his wife, and his family would have all lived in this one room. Yay, we get to live in a jail! And here we see a classic example of a prisoner's successful attempt to escape. What they did was they took tomato sauce and other acidic stuffs, and they slowly ate away the bars on the windows. I'm very sure that they did that. No, not really. I just made that up right now. Oh, that's creepy. Oh. There's somebody in there. Might not be able to see it very good in there. Oh, I thought that was a real person for a second. Is that like just another wax figure? Like, who's in there? Looking out the window, just past the cell wing, you can see the exercise ring. Oh. Prisoners walked around the ring in single file and were closely watched by a warder to ensure that there was no talking. Prisoners should be treated like Trappist monks who have taken vows of silence. So out there is the exercise ring where they walked around in a circle. Apparently, this lady by the name of Countess Margive Vives, was arrested because she inflamed the passion of the people against the police, so unlawful assembly, I think. And the Countess commented that Cork City Gaol was the most comfortable jail I've been in yet. Wow. Oh, here's a mugshot. So, yeah. This is the most comfortable jail I've ever been in. Yet. The Governor's Tunnel.
I'm reaching. I don't know if I can see.
number
23. Those two lovely ladies we just saw, we missed those at the beginning, I think. Let me get out who she is. Her name is Mary Sullivan, who is waiting to see the governor. All prisoners had to meet with the governor on arrival after first being deloused. According to prison regulations, as the close confinement of prisoners would have been a perfect breeding condition for lice. Mary is a seamstress by trade, and in 1865, she received a 7-year sentence following her 8th conviction for theft of cloth. So apparently she's coming here because she stole some cloth. For the 8th time.